Hi people, Marleen here with a new product I want to make. And I want to make a canvas with all kind of materials, little materials. I have wooden things here. I have a very old bingo card, domino, chipboard embellishments, little tiny mirrors. Buttons from old jeans, they give it with you for reserve. Cards, bingo cards, tickets, old cutouts, old things for buttons, tags from clothes I bought, fabric, well, much more. A package from a dessert from France, from clothes, map, all kind of papers. I don't know what it is. A dobbelsteen called in Holland. I don't know how it is in English. I have scribble letters, an old one, old package. What do I have more? Yeah. You see a whole bunch of mess. Once before I embossed this one, this crunch paper. I have music papers that I'm gonna use for my canvas. I prepare my canvas with the paper and gesso. And I have leftovers here from Tim Holtz papers with resist on it. So maybe I can use this also. Huh. Cards. Pins here. Wash pins. Nice button here. Well, I have a lot. And I want to put it all on one canvas. So it's get all different kind of dimensions. And I forgot one thing, one more point. I've also used prepared some metal from 10 Second Studio and put it in the embossing folder and make it three-dimensional with one of the tools of 10 Seconds. And I want to use it also on the canvas. So the canvas will be with all different kind of materials, fabrics, metal, paper, wood. And I'm going to use with it all my velvet and sorbets. Oops, mess here. And this is my box. And you see, I want to use a lot of them. So you get a whole rainbow mix of colors on the canvas. So when you look at it, you're gonna feel happy. I spray also, on this moment, I think only with the black one, with the radar. But you never know before. Oh, and I used the gesso, of course, of 10 Second Studio. Not 10 Second Studio, of Art Anthology, of course. It's a fine gesso. Do I have something other to tell? I don't think so. I will speed up the video and you will see what it's gonna be. I'm curious, just as you are. Again, always the same problem here. I have too much ideas, of too many ideas for this canvas, but I try to do as much as possible. I prepared the canvas, so laid it away. And want to show you what I do with the 10 Second Studio metals. I embossed it with the Big Shot with embossing folders and with tools. I don't know if you can see it, but it's three-dimensional now. And normally I did them with some acrylic paints and spray inks and whatever. But now I have the Art Anthology paints. And I'm gonna try that because I didn't use it on it before. What I want to do is add a gesso layer on the flowers. Let the gesso dry. And then I'm going to sand it and spray it. But first it has to dry. And I have to search for my sanding paper. Didn't thought about it. But because of the gesso, the color will be extra vibrant. So that will be a great effect. Hoppakee. Leave them there. Then I have always dirty hands. And that won't be different this time. I want to put on a layer of black velvet. How is it called? Tuxedo. And wipe it off again. But because there is it is embossed, the black velvet will stay in the lower sections, so you will get a nice dimensional effect. You see, just put it everywhere. I have sticked it on a thin chipboard, so it's much easier to work on. And well, it's 1 second drying. I do the next one, and when I finish this one, I have to clean the other one, and then if it does what I think it does, I will do, then you get a nice effect. So wipe it off. And you see, it gets an older effect. And it's going to be more three-dimensional because it will stay, the black will stay in the lower sections. And I will clean this one also. Oh, it's dirty. That's why my hands always are colored. Well, I want to dry it completely. Then I add a little Weimar Bay. And then it have an antique look, an old look. Why am I cleaning in between? Then I blow it again. Oh. And maybe I do that another time, a second time, I mean, and then the effect is maybe better. It's an experiment, I didn't test it before. you know, I'm always do what I think it's okay, and most of the time it goes well, but sometimes it doesn't work. But I think it will work awesome. I think a second layer will do good, like this. So the copper gets a rusty look. I hope you can see it. It's blinking in the light. But it will do good on the canvas, I think. Well, I'm going to finish the third one. And after that, I will speed up the video for the flowers. Because otherwise it takes too many times and you get bored. So watch it. Well, this is how it ends up dried. I think I love this result. I put on the little ones some green. I will let it dry. The big one I'm planning for something else, but that comes later. These ones away, because otherwise I ruin them, and I'm gonna play with the canvas, and now I'm really speed up the video because I think I can't stop anymore. Watch it and we will see what it's gonna be. I prepared the canvas a little further, and now we're going to add all the embellish and all the stuff I I finished it up. So far so good, because my video stopped because of the SD card in it. It was full, so I emptied it, but I finished it with all the stuff stick on the canvas. Well, you think we are there, but now the fun is beginning, because I'm now gonna take every color I can get my hands on. So don't matter what color you take, because what we want to reach is a full color canvas with all the colors you can get your hands on. And Art Anthology have many colors. And you can see this as a sort of color palette that you always can see. Oh, how was that color? So again, I'm going to speed up the video. I'm going to work with all kinds of velvet and sorbets. So it's going to be a mix of glitter, non-glitter, shimmer, and I will spray afterwards also. I have here some, you can't see it, some Scrabble letters is coming in here, but that I do at the end. And well, again, I going to speed up the video. Okay, you seen me starting with spraying with, I think it was this one, the Weimar Bay. But then my battery was low, so I finished spraying, and believe me or not, but I used many colors. Yellow, orange, blue, green, red, name it. I put it on. You see, this isn't white anymore, this isn't white anymore, this is colored, the butterflies are colored, everything is colored now. So, this I put away, but only the black one is staying. You see me using all different kind of velvets and sorbets. Well, we don't need them anymore. It's only the black one. Hartstikke idee. That is left here. And only the black one is the one that I'm going to use. Oh, it's a pity you would call me and say, what do you do? But I want to put it on because that, yeah, I don't know what it is. It puts it all together with black. So I'm gonna spray the black, if you like it or not. And if you don't, I'm sorry, but I do it. And I think I center it around the create and see what happens. Also, I am afraid to do it, but I do it. I know it will be good. Okay, then I use the heat gun and show you the result when it's dry. Well, it's dry now, but I'm having a fight with the lights because it's glimmering, shimmering, wrong. I hope you can see it. The black isn't as black when it was wet. So now it's dry and I think it's the black puts it all together. And yeah, I like the result. I will make close-up pictures, detailed pictures, so you can see the details. And yeah, I'm happy with it. So, see you in the next video and be creative. Bye bye.